Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Devar Halacha. And here's a brand new halacha for you. And it's for Friday, 22nd day of July, 16th day of Tammuz. Here we go. Well, so it's the 16th of Tammuz, and Shabbos is going to be the 17th of Tammuz. Normally, that would mean that if it had not been Shabbos, we would have been fasting on Shabbos, which is the 17th of Tammuz. But we rarely fast on Shabbos. We fast on Shabbos if it's Yom Kippur, but not for something like this 17th of Tammuz, nor for the 9th of Av, which is going to happen in 3 weeks too. So I want to discuss some of the specifics. How should you view this Shabbos, which is the 17th of Tammuz, the day that we commemorate the five sad things that happened at the beginning of the 3 weeks? The short answer is that you treat Shabbos like Shabbos. You will have all of your usual foods and everything like that. Sing your usual Zmiros and everything like that. And on Shabbos, you will show no signs of mourning whatsoever. You will treat it totally like a regular Shabbos. Some people might choose to mention it in speeches, which is totally fine. You can learn about the 17th of Tammuz, but you should have meat and wine and songs and singing. L'chadodi should have dancing if you dance. And, you know, all of whatever you do on a regular Shabbos, in short, you should continue to do. And then, well, here's an interesting one, because you will, this probably does not apply to most of you, but I've heard from some teenagers here and there that sometimes when the fast is going to be pushed off to Sunday, right? So teenagers have this cute idea for Saturday night, Sunday. They say, well, the fast starts Sunday morning at dawn, and they're right about that. So they feel like Saturday night, I'll go out with my friends, eat a lot, party, have fun, stay up all night long on Saturday night, maybe even if I'm going to be a little bit good, daven at the crack of dawn, at the earliest minyan possible on Sunday morning. And then, since I was up partying all night Saturday night, well then, after Shacharis, I'll just go to sleep and sleep away most of the day, the 17th, the 18th of Tammuz, which will be the day we'll be observing the fast. And then I'll wake up late in the afternoon, there'll only be 2-3 hours left to the fast, go daven Minchan Marav, and that's just wonderful, right? Wrong. You could probably tell I was going that way. That is not a proper way to set up your Shiva Asar v'Tammuz, nor is it the right way to set up the 18th of Tammuz when it's a pushed off fast. You should actually want to be awake if possible on the 18th of Tammuz, because remember, you've heard it from me before, a fast day is not about getting a stomach ache, it's not about getting a headache, it's actually about staying up if you can and learning about what's wrong. Why don't we have the temple back yet? What teshuva, what repentance can we still do to make everything good? That's what you're supposed to be doing on the 17th of Tammuz. Well, not this year because it's Shabbos, but on the 18th of Tammuz, that's how we commemorate the fast. I'm going to tell you real quickly about a young teenager who once said to me, it was a different fast, but he got a bad headache, and he said, it's so stupid. You know, I was trying to be a good Jew and fast and everything, and my head was pounding. I couldn't read any davening or anything because my head was pounding. So the whole thing's a disaster. And Hashem sent me some smart words, and I answered to him and said, no. Look, you're supposed to do whatever your physical body can to commemorate the sad things that have happened and do teshuva. If God sends you a headache with your fast, then that headache and that pounding is how you're serving God. If you can't read a book, He'll know that you can't read a book, but you'll still be serving God as best you can. That's the point. You'll still be serving God as best you can with the headache, with the stomach ache, with the pangs of hunger, etc. And by the way, if you do fall asleep while you're trying to read or nurse that headache or whatever, then fine. That I'm just saying, don't go and plan to do that, to plan to stay up and party, because actually here, technically speaking, the 3 weeks begin with Shabbos and Saturday night they're on, so the music and the partying probably shouldn't be happening. Only thing is that Shabbos, you know, because it's Shabbos, you're allowed to celebrate a regular Shabbos, but your Matzah Shabbos should be a regular Matzah Shabbos, a proper one. You should go to sleep, you should wake up and daven properly, say all of the extra davenings that apply to the 18th of Tammuz this year, the fast, and hey, on Matzah Shabbos, we'll give you more details about that as to what you say, what Haftorah, what Slichos, etc., but spend the day certainly thinking about repentance on Sunday. Thanks for logging on. Have a great Shabbos, a meaningful Shabbos, and then be prepared for the fast on Sunday. We'll give you those laws on Matzah Shabbos. Bye-bye.